Now please give a warm welcome to the Nils, Lofgren Band!
Thank you. 79, before some of you were born, Bob Ezrin, who was producing the, we had a lot of songs we liked, and we had some that we liked the music but not the words, so he suggested co-writing, and thought maybe we'd go talk to Lou Reed about it, which I thought was very unlikely, but we went to his studio and talked about it, and said, look, meet me in my apartment, we'll talk it through. So I met him the next week, I think it was a Monday night, and I was surprised because he said, look, I'm a big fan of the NFL and the Cowboys Redskins games. And I grew up in DC for a while, so I was excited because I didn't think about the game, and he really wanted to watch it. So we watched the game, we rooted against each other. He was a big Dallas Cowboys fan, go figure. I know, I'm with you. And, you know, we talked about it into the night, and I said, look, I got all this music, lyrics take a bit more work. He said, I'm the exact opposite. Lou said he wrote words all the time. So he said, before we rent a loft and start, you know, plowing through it together, send me a tape, and we'll go from there. So I sent him a cassette, the high-quality tape of the day. A few weeks went by, hadn't heard anything. I just kept working on the rest of the pre-production with Bob Ezrin. And then 4:30 in the morning, the phone rang, the landline rang. And I said, Nils, it's Lou Reed. And I'm like, hey, Lou. And said, look, I love that cassette you sent me. And I thought, well, that's great. I still wasn't sure why it was necessary to tell me that at 4:30. And but I was happy to hear from him. And he said, look, I've been up for 3 days and nights straight. All I've been doing is listening to your tape. And I just finished 13 complete sets of lyrics that I love. And if you like, I'll dictate them to you right now. And I was stunned because I thought, did I just write 13 songs in my sleep with Lou Reed? Anyway, I put on a pot of coffee, got the pad and pencil, and sure enough, spent a couple hours dictating meticulously all these lyrics. And he said, look, I want to use 3 songs right away on my Bells album. I said, that's great. And we used a few. I put out a couple more through the years. And then I always thought the 5 that no one ever heard, Lou would call and we'd revisit those. But tragically, of course, we lost Lou a number of years ago. And I felt like I had to get these out to share on the new record. And I also, there was a song called City Lights that he liked my chorus, and he wrote a story about Charlie Chaplin. It's a beautiful story, and I wanted to put that on my record. So, new album has 6 of those co-writes and 6 of my own. Feel good about it. We've got it here tonight if you want to check it out. But one of my favorites to sing for you now, a song called Give. I mean, I don't think there's ever a time in history where a song called, you know, Give All You Got wouldn't be appropriate. We're a little more appropriate now than maybe any time in my lifetime, but nevertheless, here's one of those co-writes called Give.
Now Thank you.
doing all right?
Yeah!
I wrote a blues song a while ago. I want to sing it for you. It's called Too Many Miles. You know, sometimes you've been down the same road too many times, and you're still on it. But anyway, one of my favorites.
Thank you.
I realize after 50 years on the road last September, I kind of have tunnel vision and I tend not to be very observant, just to block out everything except what I'm doing. My lovely wife Amy is very observant. She's trying to train me to pay more attention to my surroundings, which is probably a good thing for all of us. Nevertheless, I thought it was cool song I wrote with Lou. Whiskey or a quadruple gin and tonic, just a little sip for the burn, you know, a little false courage, makes you wince and think that somehow you have more positive energy because you drank some horrible thing that was making you wince like that. But I loved it. I loved drinking. I used to wake up and start and try to moderate all day. Thought it was the greatest medicine. I still think it's great medicine when used safely, and sadly, that's something I never did. But, yeah. Boy, they ain't in the playoffs, are they? Maybe let's think about it when they're actually not at home on the couch eating too much, watching the NBA playoffs. But anyway, so, you know, when it comes to drinking, I was having a good run, sipping day and night, thought I had it together, and then Tragically, the doctors called me in and gave me the news that I developed a terrible allergy to alcohol. When I drank, I'd break out in handcuffs. And it really bummed me out. So I had to knock that off. But anyway, have one for me, and if you have four or five, call a taxi or something, okay? Actually, the whole point of that was I gotta hydrate now. This next song, one of the ones off the new album, one of my favorites, called Too Blue to Play. I've had the title a long time, didn't know what to do with it. Kind of the idea if you just get too beat up to deal with any bull or anything but the truth and honesty, and you just don't want to hear anything else. And I finally got it written as from the perspective of a Special Forces Ranger, too many tours of duty, came back to the States just trying to hide away, mind his own business, and somehow he stumbled into a beautiful love story anyway, so I'll sing it for you. Not all surprises are bad, you know. Was an in-country ranger, had a devil by my side. I did all my country east, good chunk of my soul fried. Found a quiet battle's harbor, first met you. Swayed you slow through a lindy, and I knew we had a chance. Took our innocence and comfort, strolled it joyfully round. Showed me off a bit too much. I had heard a few boys till word got round. You seek danger like a child girl. Put that shadow cross away. 'Cause I'm too weathered, getting in too deep to play. I'm just too blue to play. I'm just too blue. love sure gets real when you're just too wife Amy asked me to sing this for you. It's called Girl in Motion. Oh, one of my favorite songs from the acoustic live album. It's a kind of an obscure song I wrote for that record and eventually put it on the flip album. But I asked Cindy Mizell to sing it tonight for us.
Warm and
5 years old, I started playing accordion. My mom and dad danced a lot, and they loved music, so when I asked for accordion lessons, they said, sure. And they didn't know they were going to pay for 10 years of them. But, you know, I started with all the waltzes and the polkas, and then I moved into classical. It was a great background when I picked up the rock and roll guitar for fun. Actually, Tommy started playing in the house, gave me my first lessons. Thank you, Tommy. Much appreciated. And we were, I've got three younger brothers. We all play and sing. We're very blessed to have parents that always encourage that. And so, you know, I started playing guitar kind of late, and by 17, I hit the road 50 years ago this last September. It's kind of a shocking number to me. And actually, this month, 35 years ago, I joined the E Street Band. Actually, this week, 50 years ago, I walked in on Neil Young and Crazy Horse. Startling numbers, startling numbers. But anyway, so, you know, I was 17 and saw Neil Young. He let me sneak into his dressing room, played some songs for him, befriended me, and my band Grin was headed to LA anyway in 3 weeks. He said, look me up when you get out there. True to his word, got out there, turned us on to David Briggs, his producer, who became my big brother and mentor, moved me into his home. And as Grin was making our way, looking for a record deal, working with David Briggs, a year later, I was 18, and Neil and David, who I saw a lot, I was living with David, he said, look, we're making this album called After the Gold Rush, and we want you to play guitar and sing and some piano for us. And these guys were heroes of mine and mentors, so I felt I owed them honesty, and I said, guys, I'm not a professional piano player. And they said, well, we know about your accordion history. You've been playing since you were 5. And I said, right. I said, we saw some geeky pictures where you won a contest. You look like a dork, but you won. And so we think you can handle some simple piano parts for us. And at that point, thank God, I just shut up and said, yes, thank you. So we recorded After the Gold Rush at Neil's home in the Topanga Canyon Hills. Had this funky old upright called Gold Rush upright. But I never left. They would take lunch breaks up on the patio, beautiful hills and beautiful afternoons, and go up, smoke a joint or whatever. I'd always stay behind and practice by myself. And this particular day, Ralphie Molina, the drummer, stayed behind, and we were working on, you know, it was a Southern Man we were working on, but it was halftime. It was like, bum, bum, whack, bum, 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 real slow, you know. After a while, you know, we got into a deep jam, but I thought I'd change it up. And I came up with this idea. Remember now, I'm just fresh out of 10 years accordion and the whole polka thing. The doom-pop. Roll out the barrel. You got a barrel of gold. And the big hit. I don't want her, you can have her, she's too fat for me. That's a disgusting song, isn't it? Awful. Shame on you, sir, whoever wrote that. Lashing out through music because you couldn't get a date. Really is disgusting. But anyway, the whole oompa thing was ingrained in me, so I started doing octaves, and Ralphie started double timing the snare, and we came up with a different groove. For lunch, they asked, what the heck is that? So that's Southern Man with a polka beat. I said, well, man, that feels great, but please don't ever say that again. But they said, that really is cool. When we get to the solo, let's shift to that gear, and then we'll break down for halftime for the last verse. Then at the end, you go back to that feel with the drums, and Neil will play a solo out. So next time you hear Southern Man, you'll notice this big shift of gears into that feel in the solo, and then again at the end. And I just thought it was cool that my square accordion days led to a cool arrangement change. But David asked asked me to start writing more for Grin on the piano, so I did, and one of the shortly after that I wrote this next piece we'll sing for. It's called Believe. It'll make you cry. Then tears black as coal. You fight so hard for some dignity. In a world out of control. I have seen hope wither beyond despair. I've seen great men's visions fade. Yet every day somewhere the sun does shine. So don't tell me it's too late to believe a little bit in yourself. Is it clear I just want to help? Charity. I know I talk a lot, but what the hell. There's this charity called the Thorn Tree Project, and in northern Kenya there's these nomadic tribes, and of course the women, the mothers, thought somehow we've got to educate our young daughters and sons. So they've got these schools now, started with 50 students, there's now 1,500, and they teach these kids and give them hope and teach them about the world and life, and that, you know, they're citizens of the world and they can have dreams and move forward. And they're doing all this with nomadic tribes. The mothers have these bracelets that they knit. This one, believe it or not, we got them to braid my name into it, which is really crazy. Amy's been dealing with them for a few years and helping them out. So they've managed to make a batch. We've got some here tonight. And just so you know, with each bracelet you buy, it gives breakfast for an entire year to one student, just with one bracelet. It's called the Thorn Tree Project. You can look it up. It's just amazing. You know, it's kind of crazy. You look, you know, we're watching the whole world and the madness on TV, and you see these people with nothing coming up with these amazing ideas to help each other, and women and children that are less than, and people that are prejudiced against. And then, you know, these incredibly trillionaire people with all this power and money just ravaging everything at the expense of all human life and mankind itself. It's just crazy. So we're trying to turn it around, but these mothers are doing that in Kenya for their children. So if you feel like it, check out the Thorn Tree Project. Pick up a bracelet and help them, okay? Thinking about better times and better people, this famous Carole King song I'd like to sing called Goin Back.
Trains, no more dreams.
again, we got this new album, Blue with Lou. We feel great about it. And Kevin and Andy came to our home in Arizona. We tracked it live there, and Cindy came in and sang beautifully all over the record. And I just thought, you know, we were, Kevin and I and Andy have played before in the past, years gone, and we thought, wouldn't it be fun to go out and play again? And thought, yeah, well, everyone's always so busy, it's unlikely, but when the time came, they all agreed to come, including the great Cindy Mizell, and here we are. Going way back, it's funny, I dropped out of high school and ran away to Greenwich Village, and I got lucky, and despite some rocky times, 50 years later, here I am. But my band, my first professional band that recorded Grin, we needed another guitar player and keyboard player, and had the grand idea that my brother Tommy could quit school and join the band. My mom and dad said, no, no, no. One dropout is enough shame in our family. And then Tommy came up with the great idea, well, why don't I go to summer school, take as many courses as I can, and get my diploma early and still miss my last year. And believe it or not, my cool parents agreed to that, as long as we got this diploma. So thanks, Mom and Dad, and Tom. I couldn't have faced that. I was proud of Tommy for doing it. Anyway, I'd like to introduce you to this great band. On keyboards, guitars, and vocals, my dear brother, Tommy Lofgren. Way back in 77, Andy and I met and produced Came to Dance. We've been good friends and played together ever since. On drums, the great Andy Newmark. Shortly after that, dear friend Skunk Baxter turned me on. I needed a bass player, and I never imagined such a great friend and bass player would show up, but years later, we're still doing it. The great Kevin McCormick on bass. And she needs no introduction, but I knew she couldn't make it, but I've had to ask, and she said she'd come sing with us. The great Cindy Mizell. Wonderland album, I think. Yes.
Thank you.
my family's make you run. If my daddy ever caught me kissing her, I believe he would shoot his son. But we're growing up, and there'll come a day when the real world makes us run away. Now we live in shame and play their city game. Soon we'll be gone and I won't have to say goodbye. I saw you last morning, I cried my sins out. You were rain and I washed away. I meet the kind of friends that always seem to end. And I laugh when I start to say, I wonder like a cloud when it comes to loving. This lonely heart sure ain't nothing new. I was told by a wise man in my soul, she's gonna always stop loving you. She leaves me up at evening. always am. I meet a kind of friend that always am. I meet the kind of friend that always am. I meet the kind of friend that always am. And I love when I start to say. Going on a 19-city run through Vermont, so come see us again if you can. And, so grateful. Give me a minute, I'll help you to come out after the show and sign anything you like. And remember the Thorn Tree Project, got a new album to feel good about, so check it out if you're up to it. I'll sign anything you want, except body parts, no body parts. Over the first atmosphere's heavy, world title is on the line. Strong and proud is much older. I'm a faster, I'm in my prime. Third only starts to tire. Open cut boy, his left eye. Smelling blood, attack is relentless. In the box seats, I see his girl cry. Can't even see. On this title, now it don't feel right. Fight back tunes wanna destroy his life. Now watch me. Thank you.
start.
Well, my manager kept telling me if I want to be great. Said I better wise up and sing my songs straight. I said, listen here, you fool, in order to survive, I've got to be my dirty self. I won't play no jive. Let me hear you, New York. Steal anything you want, just not instruments. Setlist, that's fine. Someone else in the band will tell me what we're doing. It's no worries. Thank you.
Hold me close, try and understand. I work all day, out in the hot sun. Stay with me now till the morning comes.
Yeah.
Just another room, just another town. Same old crazy people hanging around still, yeah. Shine silently. Slipping in a space, coming down alone. Feel like packing all my bags, running home, well, yeah. Shine silently.
New York. Thank you.